I'm sure that game was exciting for people to watch, and I don't think that Wichita State's record is any indication of what type of basketball team they have. I know Jody's struggled with injuries just like us, and I think she got her big kid back, which helped. But it was a fun basketball game, and I think both teams battled, and just really proud of our team for coming out with a win.
Talk about Graves and Carter and what they were able to do for you, particularly down the stretch.
Well, I just think Graves is kind of our glue to our offense, Dan, and I thought she came up with huge rebounds for us, 11 offensive rebounds, and she fought pretty hard. Hit big free throws at the end, but I just thought she battled really. She was a tough kid tonight, and she was, you know, they had to come at us and be physical with us, and I thought she handled them being physical. I thought Mercedes could have handled it a little bit more, but Bashar was doing what she needed to do, and Carter, you know, she hit big shots when we needed them. Finally, I mean, she hit two shots that were great shots for her along the baseline, and they were huge shots for us. And I stuck her at the point. I just thought she would settle us down a little bit, and I'm just really proud of her. You know, I think tonight what we did different is we got hustle plays. I thought we played hard. Now we got to cut down on our turnovers, but I just thought we played hard. And just a credit to them. They went after it and did some really, really nice things.
What did you see from the turnovers? I mean, it was a number of different things.
Yeah.
I mean, post entries, passes, inbound plays. I mean, is it?
Yeah. I think the majority of our turnovers, and at least we were given the effort of trying to advance the ball. I thought the last two, we stole it, and then we were trying to feed in transition. Those were two costly ones, but you know we're attacking it, and I thought they were turnovers. Most of our turnovers were us attacking the basket, and we had a lot in the past away from the basket. So we got to cut those downs, and you know we just give up too many threes, and we work on it, but we help in when we shouldn't. But they hit some big shots, and the threes kept them in the game. So we got to get a little bit more discipline guarding the three-point shot.
You went to the full court pressure in the second half. Did you just feel like we got to change the tempo here? We got to do something. It was kind of like it was sort of just playing out.
Yeah.
At their tempo.
Well, we started off. I thought we did a good job starting off, and then the second half, we went to a zone. Just to try to change their tempo, and we changed it. We went to a 2-2-1 press. We went to a man press. We went to a 1-2-2 press. We pulled out all the stops.
What was the zone you were in? Was it up?
We're in a 3-2.
Was it a 3-2? Okay.
Yeah, and I thought we needed to do something just to break their rhythm, and I thought we did, but very smart. We went out on their 3-point players, and they got the ball inside to 35, and she got some and-one plays there. So I thought it was, you know, they did what they needed to do to get it to the free throw line. But
you mentioned this in passing. Does Russell need to be? She need to be tougher, more aggressive.
She's 6'6", being guarded by what six feet. So. She's just got to get used to people playing under her, and meaning people are going to bump her. And I thought she got good looks, but she was shooting not squared up to the basket, and those are things that we can work on.
It looked like she passed up some looks too. She passed out one time and threw it right to a
yeah.
player. I mean, did she?
Well, I think she's got to get in the flow. She went 2-for-7, and I thought when she did go to the basket and was squared up. She made great looks. She shot over the rim. But, she's got to get used to people coming under her and Gardner that way. But, you know, for the most part, she fumbled a lot of passes today, and she's got great hands. But we can't feed the ball to her down at her knees too. So there's some things we gotta get better at. But, you know, and she's a better passer than what she's – she had four turnovers, and she's a better passer than what she showed tonight.
Braves had the sequence where she misses the two free throws, but then comes right back in,
gets the steal,
scores, and then doesn't miss a free throw the rest of the
Yeah.
way. What was that switch that flipped for her? Was it missing the free throws, or what was it?
Well, I think she just got mad because she missed the free throws. She just said to me coming in, she goes, I said, you know, I was talking about how hard she played, and she goes, I missed my two free throws. And I went, but you made four when it counted. But it was a huge steal. It was a huge steal for her. And I think one thing you see that's gotten better about Bashar's game is she's extended her game, and she got a steal, went down like a guard, handled the ball, shot a layup. I don't know, 2 years ago, a year ago, she would have been able to do that. But she's put a lot of time in stretching the defense and doing a lot of ball handling. So really trust her on the perimeter.
Coach, you knew that Jody's teams were, I mean, going to grind like that.
Yep.
Anything they do tonight surprise you?
No. No, I've said this before. I think Jody's team takes on her personality, and they play hard. They play hard, and she expects a lot from them. And I thought they delivered tonight. I mean, she's undermanned, and we understand playing with a short bench with injuries. So, I thought her kids, they laid it all out there today, and I'm not surprised of how hard they played and the type of defense, the type of offense, everything they did, I thought was all out, and I thought they did a great job. She's done a great job with this basketball team, losing the kids that she's lost to graduation, and so I think they're young, but she'll get them there.
Coach,